In this video, we'll discuss variable air volume systems and VAV boxes. The VAV system is the most used HVAC system in commercial buildings. We'll discuss several methods of controlling VAVs, how VAVs work with variable frequency drives, and the components that make up a VAV box. The air handler varies the amount of airflow, CFM, at the overall system level based on demand required by the zone level VAV boxes. The VAV boxes regulate the flow, CFM, to a zone or the spaces in relation to the demand of the temperature sensor in the space. So you have basically two levels of airflow control. It starts with the VAV box at the zone level where the room temperature sensor determines one of three modes of operation, which we'll discuss later. The next level of airflow control happens at the air handler. The air handler responds to what is happening to all of the VAV boxes attached to the system. Let's start at the air handler. The air handler will deliver a constant temperature of 55 degrees Fahrenheit or 13 degrees Celsius, supply air to the VAV boxes. While the supply air stays constant, the volume, CFM, of air will vary based on the total demand of all the zones on the system. There are several control strategies to adjust the speed of the fan, which we'll discuss later. As the VAV boxes open or close their damper due to demand called for by the temperature sensor in the space, the pressure in the main supply air duct will either increase or decrease. This pressure change is picked up by a static pressure sensor in the main supply air duct. As the pressure increases in the main supply duct because the VAV boxes are closing their dampers and are adjusting their dampers towards the minimum open setting, which could be around 30%, the air handler supply fan VFD, variable frequency drive, slows down the fan. The opposite will happen due to the VAV boxes opening because of increased demand in the space for more air. In this case, the VFD will cause the supply fan to speed up when the pressure in the main supply air duct drops. The VFD will try to maintain the speed, the RPM, of the fan motor so that the static pressure in the duct at the location of the static pressure sensor maintains some minimum set point, such as 1.25-inch static pressure. The static pressure sensor sends a signal to the VFD and the speed of the fan is adjusted according to the set point required. So as you can see in the diagram, the VAV damper goes from a minimum of 30% open, whatever the minimum required to meet your ASHRAE 62 ventilation requirements, all the way to the damper being 100% open in full cooling mode. So there are three basic modes in this control strategy. One is the cooling mode where the heating hot water valve is closed and the VAV damper modulates from 30 to 100% open in order to satisfy the temperature sensor. And then mode two, again, is the dead band mode, is when there is no need for cooling or heating, so the damper stays in its minimum position to meet the ventilation requirements of ASHRAE 62. And then mode three is the heating mode where the VAV damper remains in the minimum position and the heating hot water valve modulates open to satisfy the heating requirements of the space. The functions of a VAV box is that it has a damper at its inlet moved by an actuator that is controlled by the controller that takes its command from a temperature sensor. The process is very simple. When the temperature sensor in this space calls for cooling, it sends a command to the VAV box controller, which then adjusts the supply air flow rate. The adjustment is done by an actuator, which is, you know, could be electric, pneumatic, DDC, everybody's going to DDC, and it rotates that VAV box inlet damper open or closed in increments to satisfy the space requirement. So that it has an airflow sensor at the inlet of the box, and that is used to adjust the damper position by measuring the airflow at the inlet of the box. So the airflow sensor measures total pressure and static pressure to determine the velocity pressure, which helps the controller determine the CFM through the inlet of the VAV box. So what you get is you get velocity pressure equals total pressure minus static pressure. Now you have a reheat coil depending on the zone. Most exterior zones will have a reheat. A lot of the interior zones won't, unless you're in a hospital or some other special space. That provides heating, either through heating hot water, steam, or electric. The use of electric is limited in some jurisdictions due to energy codes. So one of the key elements of understanding VAV is to understand how it's zoned. So how do you determine a VAV zone? So before we get any deeper into the subject, we need to cover the basics of zoning. So zoning is how the engineer divides up the building into separate VAV zones, with each zone getting its own VAV box. So to keep costs down, it's best to limit the amount of VAV boxes used, as each box adds additional cost for material, labor, controls, and electrical. So after a heating and cooling load is completed on a building, the spaces can be divided up into zones. Each individual zone should have a similar load profile and be served by the same VAV box. So a typical zone may be offices that share a southern glass exposure or interior spaces. The idea of zoning is to break down large areas of a building into smaller zones with similar load profiles. When a zone on the south-facing portion of a building is calling for maximum cooling, the north-facing zones may be in minimum cooling or in heating mode. So zoning allows different spaces the ability to provide heating or cooling and vary the flow, CFM, depending on the demand of the zone's temperature sensor. All the zones on a floor of a high-rise may be fed from the same air handler, but each zone can adjust its CFM according to their specific space needs. Depending on the size of the floor plate, there may be two air handlers per floor, or for smaller floors, the air handler may feed more than one floor. The air handler can be located on the floor within a mechanical room, or located on the roof or in a basement. The supply air is considered the high side of the system, the high side being the main supply air duct from the air handler to the inlet of the VAV box, which would be the demarcation between high and low. The main is considered upstream of the VAV box, while downstream of the VAV box is considered the low side. The air handler will provide 55 degree supply air to the VAV box. The VAV box will then determine how much air CFM to pass through to the space based on the demand of the space. The air handler is sized to meet the maximum block load of the area it serves. The block load is basically the peak heating or cooling load of all the zones combined. It is not the total CFM of all the peaks of each zone, but the total based on the worst month, day, and time of year where the total block, is at its maximum load. Each zone is reacting differently to the early morning sun. Some zones are in cooling mode with their dampers at different percentages of being open, while other zones are in heating and one zone is off and receiving minimum air for ventilation. This is a very basic diagram of how zones may differ and why it's important to consider how spaces are grouped together, as each space may have a different solar exposure and cooling load profile. corner spaces are often difficult to include with other spaces because they have two exposures. It's like living on the corner in your block. You have two streets. Looking at the image, we can see that there are two cooling zones between corner spaces that are on the south exposure that can be grouped together into one zone. The same is true for two zones in between the corner spaces on the north exposure. So those could be grouped together because they're going to act the same. If you had interior zones, they would be separated from any exterior zones because interior zones are often exclusively in cooling mode due to internal heat gains and lack of heat loss from any exterior surfaces. During cooling mode, the VAV box will modulate between a minimum CFM set point and the calculated design maximum cooling CFM set point based on the zone's peak cooling demand. When the hot summer arrives and the sun shines through the window and conducts heats through the walls and roofs, the need for cooling will be sensed by the temperature sensor in the space, which will call for the VAV box to open its damper and let more cold air into the room. Or if you're in a room located within the interior of the building, like a conference room, then the heat from the people, lights, and plug loads will cause the temperature sensor to initiate an opening of the VAV box damper for more cold air. Now, during heating mode for exterior zones, and in certain cases, interior zones, there will be a reheat coil, a heating hot water coil, or an electric heater attached to the VAV box. The reheat coil can be served by heating hot water, steam, or electric. When in heating mode, the flow, the CFM through the VAV box, will be at a minimum set point to avoid wasting energy. Because remember, the air handler is sending 55 degree cold air to all the VAV box, whether they need heating or cooling. So you don't want to send a ton of cooling air when you want to be in heating mode. So there's a minimum setting for ventilation requirements. So that air is coming at 55 degrees, and then you're going to have to heat it up. So it's a bit of a waste of energy, but that's at the minimum set volume of air. So this primary supply air will also bring, you know, the minimum mandatory ventilation air, that's outside air for freshness. In some space systems, the supply air temperature could be increased to a temperature that is just cool enough to cool the most demanding zone when its VAV box set to a maximum flow, thereby saving additional energy. So that's an additional way to get around that minimum CFM flow for heating. So the heating hot water valve will modulate open, providing a range of heating water flow, GPM, to meet the heating load. So you got the minimum CFM set point, can see be somewhere between 30 and 50% of maximum cooling. Minimums are set by code jurisdiction, so that minimum ventilation rate is always achieved. In California, you know, see Title 24, Section 120.1 for requirements for ventilation and indoor air quality. Now, the use of electric heat is not improved in various jurisdictions, so check your local code for approved sources for heating requirements. We'll mention two control strategies for optimizing energy efficiency using a VAV system. These are 1. Constant static pressure control method, 2. Static pressure reset, required if there is a DDC system to the zone level. When the VAV boxes are connected to a building automation system that monitors the function and status of the boxes, there are various options for control. This is based on using a DDC system. 1, constant static pressure control method. Usually, a pressure sensor is installed 2/3 of the way down the main supply air duct. When VAV boxes start closing their dampers because they need less cooling, an increase in pressure will occur. When the static pressure in the supply duct increases due to the VAV boxes closing their inlet dampers, the static pressure in the main supply air duct increases. The pressure sensor in the duct will send a signal to the variable frequency drive, the VFD, causing the supply and return fans to slow down or reduce its RPM. If the pressure in the duct decreases because the VAV boxes are opening due to the need for additional cooling, the pressure sensor will send a signal to increase the fan speed RPM. The pressure sensor is set to maintain a constant pressure in the main supply duct, which often causes excess static pressure to be provided when compared to option 2 next. Option 2 is static pressure reset. The use of this strategy is required by Title 24 for those who live in California and ASHRAE 90.1 for systems that have DDC to the zone level. The static pressure setting in the main supply duct is reduced to a point where one VAV box damper is nearly full open. This is the zone that requires the most pressure. This would require that the VAV box actuators can report their damper position best performed when an analog output. Look for trim and response logic for more information. These options provide a good opportunity to save energy by reducing the fan speed and possibly increasing the supply air temperature in small increments with continuous polling. If the supply temperature can be reset above the economizer set point, then the compressors can stage off and the cooling can be provided by modulating the return air and outside air dampers to deliver the desired supply air temperature. In summary, the use of variable air volume, VAV, has been shown to save energy when combined with a supply fan VFD. As the demand in the spaces fluctuate, the VAV box dampers open or close proportionately, and the air handler fans respond through various control strategies. Variable air volume systems save more energy than a constant volume system. If you like that video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.